So, a while ago, I was watching the Awesome Death Speech on YouTube. And after seeing it a few times, I noticed a few details in editing and sound design that kind of surprised me and that I want to share here. But first, go watch the clip for yourself and then come back.
The world of men will fall.
So the first thing I noticed is a cut at the end of this encounter. Seen it? Let's play it again. So this is clearly a jump cut. It's nothing special in cinema, but for Lord of the Rings, it's kinda an atypical cut. It's used throughout the movies, it's very selective, and I'm wondering why they did it. So I want to see what other options they had to avoid the cut and understand why it was necessary. The first option to avoid a jump cut would be to use an extra reaction of Gandalf.
The world of men.
Showing Gandalf twice is pretty useless because we already had his reaction, so it doesn't add anything, except time, and the movie is already 3 hours long. The second option would be to leave out the reaction of the Witch King where he looks back at Gandalf. Personally, I think this would be the worst option because I really love this reaction, and even though you don't see his face, he really makes us feel uncomfortable. There is also a third option because there's a third person present, Pippin, the hobbit that is with Gandalf. I think they didn't do this because the scene is not about him. This moment is a showdown between Gandalf, representing the good, and the Witch King, representing evil. Cutting in Pippin would disturb this moment. So the only option they had left is using a jump cut. But this moment is so fantastic that no one notices this anyway. That reaction shot also works because of another reason. There's a subtle drop in sound. We can even see it in the waveform. This drop in sound helps to highlight that this is a turning point. A bit later in the scene, after this awesome speech and then some more awesomeness, something interesting happens in the music. As they get ready to attack, the music builds up to an epic momentum. But instead of making the music even louder and faster, they choose to switch to something completely different, to something that reminds me of medieval music. This contrast works so well because it's unpredictable and feels fresh. On top of that, it gives a deeper emotional meaning to this attack. The Rohan and their cavalry are clearly inspired by medieval times and Celtic tribes. This music reflects that and makes us emotionally more involved with their battle for survival. The next switch in music is 1 minute later. When the cavalry hits the orcs, the music suddenly drops. I actually talked about this in a different video. If you want the violence to have maximum impact, don't use music. And that's exactly what they do here. By dropping the music, they leave room for the sound effects and let us feel the slaughter. The music comes back when we see that our heroes have the upper hand. One last thing that I noticed is the shot at the end. It's the only slow-mo shot in the battle, and we've actually seen this before. The first half of the shot is cut in right before the cavalry hits. For some reason, they only cut back to it 30 seconds later, well into the battle. I can't figure out the reasons for this, but it's a fun detail in this already awesome scene. Anyway, that's it for now. See you next time!